There is a story that's been going around all my life. I've heard a lot of versions of it, but it's real funny. And the thing that makes it so funny, it's not hard for me and you, being small town folk, to realize how an individual can really love a dog. There was a man in South Mississippi who was illiterate. He couldn't read or write. And he had an old boy named W.L. W.L. Ledbetter. This old man was Uncle Crack. Uncle Crack Ledbetter. He was a distant cousin to Uncle Versey. Well, old man Crack Ledbetter got him a job at the railroad at an early age and saved his money. And his life's ambition was to educate his only son, W.L. Send him off to college. W.L. was a smart young man. He finished high school. He took the money and caught the city of New Orleans and went to Batesville, Mississippi. He got on the bus at Batesville and went to University of Mississippi at Oxford and enrolled and was making good grades, but he spent more money than he should have spent. And he got to thinking, what is it I can do to impress my father that he would send me some more money and wouldn't be griping about me spending so much up here? And old W.L. got to thinking, Papa's done sent me a bunch of money, and I done run through it, even though I'm making my grades, my soul. I need me some more money. I like getting in these here social things and spending a little money, eating them foot-long hot dogs. So he wrote home and told his mama that could read, said, you tell Papa that old Rover, that dog he worships, that dog he loves, that dog he thinks more of than me, that if he'll send old Rover up here on the train to me and $100, I got a professor up here that can teach old Rover to read. And that old man went wild. Oh, have mercy, get old Rover ready. Paul Rover can read, and I ain't never been able to read. I have a son and a dog that can read. Oh, he sent old Rover up there with $100. Wasn't long after about 3 months, that $100 run out. Old boy said, I need me some more money. He wrote his mama again, said, send $200 more. Tell Papa there's a professor up here that'll teach old Rover to talk. He actually can say a few words. Send the $200. Old boy graduated. It's time to go home. He done got his degree. He don't know what he's going to do. He got to figure out something. Because the old man's done told everybody in town, boy's coming home tomorrow and going to bring old Rover. Y'all come. He's going to read and talk to you. Train pulled into the station. That old man is there with his best suit of clothes on. People got off. Band was playing, everybody was squalling. Old man didn't see W.L. Everybody got off the train and he looked, and W.L. done got off of the last car up there about 200 yards. And the old man run up there, said, son, where's Rover? Where's Rover? He said, Papa, I got off up here by myself. I just wanted to share this with you. He said, we is coming along up yonder, around a curve. That city of New Orleans is doing 97 miles an hour. Me and old Rover was sitting there. He was sitting over there on a chair reading the paper. And said he is telling me what the news was in the paper. And then he lowered that paper down and he looked over at me and he said, W.L., I can't wait to get to your mama to tell her what I saw the maid and your daddy doing one time. And W.L. started crying, said, Papa. It just infuriated me and made me so mad that an animal that me and you love as much as we love that dog would tell a low-down stinking thing on you like that. And before I knew it, I'd grabbed him in his collar and I'd flung him off the back of that train and he hit on them cross ties and bounced and went out a deep ditch. Said, I know it killed him. And the old man looked up and said, son, are you sure that lying dog is dead?